incredible. She's superficial. She's complicated.
Leeds had been forced into defence from the start, but they shocked the Villa fans after 11 minutes. Terry Connor was harassed but scrambled the ball to Alex Sabea, who needed a deflection to open the scoring. 7 minutes from half-time and the shot from Tony Morley, but Gary Shaw helped it into the net.
So this is Christmas, and what have you done? Another year over, and a new one just begun. And so this is Christmas, I hope you have.
Leeds have Hart and Parlane poised to make their runs from the back post. And will it come for Greenough? And the flag is up, and the referee waves it away.
For weak and for strong, the rich and the poor.
John Lukic in the Leeds goal was in impressive form, sitting on the ground to make a save from McKenzie. And Lukic showed more conventional ability when Phil Boyer's pass reached Kevin Reeves in the penalty area. A draw seemed the most likely result until a minute from time, when City got the reward their earlier play merited. Lukic beaten by Reeves' half volley. Manchester City 1, Leeds United 0.
Take the lead, and Danny Thomas gets the goal. bit off Blair, and Sabella might make something of it. The linesman was the key figure in that episode, because Pat Partridge looked across to him and he made no signal. Jacobs is the defender. Pat Partridge has given the penalty. It's 1-1. Well, Kevin Hurd is a player in the Leeds dressing room with a reputation as a man with nerves of steel.
Have you any complaints about the goal itself?
Not really. As I say, we don't query referees' decisions at this club. We accept them and we get on with them.
Obviously very disappointed there.
Very disappointed. As I say, Peter was asking me after the game if we have, you know, reporters any injuries and that. The only injuries we had was broken hearts, because the way we performed out there, we deserve to win.
The main problem appears to be that you haven't scored a goal for the last four matches.
But we haven't conceded many. When you look before myself and my staff game here, we're conceding goals left, right and centre, and they still wasn't putting them away there. At the moment, I would say we're probably one of the hardest teams in the division to score a goal against.
Tries one from there. Good save by Lukic. Martinez. Archibald. Good touch from him. And it's there. Here's Crooks. And Hoddle. And a good save. What do you have to do, he says. This is Graham. They see him a little bit too hard that time on Flynn. 6'1" against 5'3¾". And the 6'1", as you might expect, came off Bella. Oh, a mistake there. And it's there! And so it's 1-1. Despite the fact that I would imagine Spurs must have had something like 70% of the possession.
Before today, Manchester United, despite having a desperately disappointing season, hadn't lost at Old Trafford. But in their past six games, they'd managed just two goals, and their goal famine was to continue. John Lukic, the Leeds goalkeeper, made several good saves. And in the second half, as Manchester United dominated the game and Leeds hung on grimly, he was repeatedly called on to rescue his side. He did his job just well enough. That save from Lou Macari, and not long afterwards, came perhaps the turning point of the match. Steve Coppell came so near to breaking the deadlock. A crowd of almost 46,000 became increasingly frustrated as Old Trafford seemed to be heading for its sixth goalless draw of the season. The most expensive forward in Manchester United's history is Gary Birtles. He came to Old Trafford last October and he still can't score a goal here. With 5 minutes left, Leeds had only twice worried United's defence, but now they won the game. Brian Flynn the scorer, and Leeds had proved conclusively that scoring goals is all that matters in football. Manchester United 0, Leeds 1.